So, George, you came all the way from Nigeria across the Sahara to Libya and then to Sicily and then here to Italy. So, tell us, can you tell us what it was like?
Yeah, well, I thank God for everything. About the way from Nigeria to Libya. If not God, I don't think I would still be alive today. I left Nigeria. From Nigeria, I went to Niger. From Niger to Agadez. From Agadez to Libya. So from Libya, I spent some time there. Those Arab people, the one that God bless, they tracking me for like 2 years. Then they leave me this year. So I vow for God when I succeed to Italy, I will give my life to God and I will do the work of God. So now I'm in Italy, so I have to live my life with God.
So what was it like crossing the Sahara Desert?
No, Sahara Desert is hard, but it's God. When you have the God in you, so it's only God can lead somebody to pass Sahara Desert. Sahara Desert is not just easy.
So how many days did it take you to get across?
So for Sahara Desert, we spent 4 days. It's for 4 days, yes. For speed, not stopping, just be going for 4 days. Then we get to Libya in the downtown. They call it Katron. From Katron, we get to Saba. Then from Saba, we have to pay for that money to Tripoli. Then from Tripoli, we have to come to Suprata. Then we leave Suprata, then we get to Sicily.
So, when you were crossing the Sahara, how did you cross on like it's not a, there's no buses, right?
No, it's that motor they call Hilos. Hilos, that big Hilos. Yeah, the one they put, use to hold wood at the back. The driver will be driving like 4 people at the front, where like crowd of people will sit like this bike. Then from there you have to stand with wood. So we spend like 4 days with nothing, no food when our food finished, but just the grace of God that lead us there.
So did you find water in the desert? Where how did you drink?
No, we find no. We get some water. The water is not good. After we spent like 3 days, then we got some place in desert is hole there. So we have to fetch some water, but the water is not good. But we don't have ocean. We have to test it before we get to Libya.
And so, tell us about the crossing on the Mediterranean. How many people on your boat?
Our boat, but in our boat, I cannot remember amount of people that will be in the boat, but we see that we are more than 100. We are more than 100 because that day was night, so they took everybody on one line. From there, when you take the boat to the sea, they have to drive everybody back again. From there, they will be bringing people 10-10. So when they take the woman first, they take me like I was the 14. So I did not know how many them break on my back before the thing feed up. But if I'm not mistaken, I know that it's more than 100 people in one
So
boat.
what was the boat like? Were you frightened you were going to sink?
Yeah, the boat is like, if you don't have, many people are dying in the boat, but where you have the grace of God, it's only God will take you down to from Libya to Sicily, because the boat, once it leak, everybody will die. Then once the one person busts the lapa-lapa, everybody have to die. Then once the engine break down, then the wave of the sea will be taking you to different direction. So I thank God for my whole journey. My Lapa Lapa did not have engine problem. Then we come successful. Then we arrive in Blue Sea. Then we got rescued around 10 o'clock in the morning as we leave Libya around 12. So we get to try Sicily, Blue Sea around 10 in the morning. So we got rescued. So UK rescue us after that and transfer us to Spain. So that is where I found myself in Italy, in Sicily. Then before they introduced me to your church. So already I'm already vowed for my God that anything may God take me down to Italy, I have to serve my God. Because I'm a son of God. If not God, I don't think I would be alive today.
Praise
so
God.
I want people to help me to thank God for my life today.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So, Peter, you want to add something?
Yes, yes. We are here to thank God to what God done for us, for Nigeria, to Italy. When I'm in the Libya camp, God is because of God. I don't die for there, but God said that I will serve him to the where I will
so,
live.
So you also made a vow like Henry, yeah, that you are like George, that you will serve God.
Yes. When I'm in Libya, I make everything. I say, God, where she help me to cross this sea. I will serve him. I will not stop serving. We tell God that any money we have, we can give him. But now, money is not in our hand. But later, when we come, we shall know what we go do. But we want to tell you to thank God what you're doing for me to bring me Italy here. When I deliver me nothing see, because many people, my friend is going back from Tripoli. Me just I be that time me hungry, me think like by 3 days or 1 week I will go back for Tripoli. But that time before 7 o'clock we don't wake up praying God, telling God to open the sea, open the weather to go to us. The man of the charge of the camp crossing us said that it is falling Libya. The sea is not good. We stay more than 3 months. We started to play the prayer. Is the only God we reach the time where I tell come and we reach more than 3 days, no food. Now is water that I taking. Is this next day I started giving us food every day once. So they give food every day once. It's because of work of God. It's making them give us their food. I want to help me to thank God what you have done for me. You make me to cross the sea. Our boat make us nothing happened to our boat. No quarrel, nobody die. The boat were first cross before we can cross. The commercial man were close. They said that more than 30 people die. Until my friend die. Until make us our own, our boat. Our many people were believe God for.
Yeah, thank God.
Thank God. Many people were believe God. All of us there for the boat. Even for the boat we are praying. She make us our boat is on. Nobody die. Nothing. She make us reach here. I want me to be able to ask God to open my heart.
Praise God.
To serve God. I have praise God for this time around.